Well, we're here at Jacobson Park, and as many people may have noticed, the original entrance to the park has been removed, and we'd like to kind of explain why that's going on. It's a very exciting project for us. We've been looking forward to it for some time. The original entrance with the brick gates was built in the 70s, in the 1970s, and over the last several years, there had been several traffic accidents involving our entrance. Part of the problem was that the entrance gates were very close to the Richmond Road corridor, to the right-of-way. So several years ago, we decided that for safety reasons, we needed to redesign the entrance. The goal of this project, of this phase of the project, is simply safety. And there's a number of features that has to do with. One is capacity. We have a lot of big events here at the park. And as anyone who's come to, say, Free Friday Flicks and tried to get in or out, sometimes we have big backups and it's inconvenient for people. So we want to make sure that everybody can get in and out of the park. So through this phase of the project, we're actually doubling our capacity. We'll have two lanes in and two lanes out, which will help more people get in off of Richmond Road safely and quicker and get them out onto Richmond Road and out of the park safer and quicker. Traffic engineering is also going to re-engineer the signal so that the signal will now detect bicycles. Right now, the technology that's being used does not detect bicycles. It takes a car to actually trigger the light, and so there'll be a camera installed. And so now if a cyclist needs to cross and get from the park out onto Old Richmond Road, the light will trip and will give them an extended signal time so that they can get across safely. Later this fall, when we come back with the aesthetic portion of the project, we will be adding new pillars and columns and park signage, landscaping, but all of that will be pushed back so that it is much more safe. In addition to the safety, though, of the aesthetic portion, we're excited to give it a new look. It's going to incorporate some columns, some gates, landscaping, and we are going to have horse farm fencing. And we feel that that's a much more appropriate image to give people, especially visitors, as they come in from Richmond Road.
As a young kid, Lexington Parks and Rec always had a place for us to do something. It helped me in a healthy way to compete, but also learn how to be humble in victory and to have some dignity when we lost. Learning to do that allowed me to get to the point where I matured not only as an individual, but also as an athlete. I am a product of Lexington Parks and Recreation.
Healthy activity for the whole family when you visit Kentucky is biking the bluegrass. Here you will find many bike trails that Lexington has to offer. These 12-foot wide shared use trails are designed for activities like running and walking and also higher speed activities like skating and biking. The longest shared use trail Lexington has to offer is the 9-mile Legacy Trail. This beautiful trail provides the opportunity to exercise, connect with nature, and learn more about our unique environment. Apart from enjoying the fresh air and exercise, there's also beautiful interpretive art that's been painted in certain areas all along the trail. So this trail offers fun, exercise, and cultural opportunities for visitors of all ages.
The Legacy Trail has been fantastically received. People love this trail. I get emails all the time saying how great it is. I've been out here on weekends, and it's almost too crowded. People love it so much.
Another shared use trail in Lexington is the Town Branch Trail. This 2.2-mile trail has many opportunities to see birds and wildflowers along the way. There are other great trails, like at Shillitoe Park, where there's a 1.5-mile shared use trail that connects to the 1-mile Lafayette Trail, making a total loop of 2.5 miles. There are many bike trails that you can enjoy in and around Lexington. You can visit the Parks and Recreation website at lexington.gov to see a complete list of bike trails and their maps so you can go biking in the bluegrass. See you next time.
Thank you. we've done to start the 2012 golf season is we've lowered all of our rates to become more affordable to the general public who play our facilities. Basically, we did a $2 across the board decrease on all of our fees, and then we introduced some new fees for military, ex-military personnel. We offer discounts for UK students and Transylvania students. We offer discounts to military, either retired or active. We offer discounts for persons with disability, and all LFUCG employees also receive discounts off our green fees. We moved our senior age to age 50 now instead of 60, so you get further discounts at age 50. And women, all ladies get a discounted rate Monday through Friday now. It used to be just Tuesday, but it's Monday through Friday. And beginning August 1, this loyalty card is going to be reduced to $50, and it will take you through the rest of this year where you would get $5 off any round that you play for $50 in advance. Each of our four major courses, Tate's Creek, Lakeside, Kearney Hill Golf Links, and the Gabe Brewer Junior course at Picadome, have their championship facilities, but they have fully stocked golf shops. We carry the latest and greatest in all golf merchandise. If you go into one of our shops and you're looking for something that we don't have, we probably have it at another facility, but we're carrying all the latest brands, all the hot stuff, the TaylorMade rocket balls, the new Titleist line of woods and putters, and all the new balls. We have the Puma clothing line that Ricky Fowler has made popular. So we have all that merchandise in stock. If you're looking for something in particular, we have it. All of our courses are open basically 7 days a week from daylight to dark, and you can make tee times up to 7 days in advance by calling the shop of your choice, and you can make your reservation that way. The easiest way to find out stuff about us is go to the website, which is www.lexingtonky.gov/parks, and just go to the golf section, or you can call any of our facilities, or you can call our main office, which is 288-2968. We have a Facebook page called Play Golf Lexington. It's in its infancy stages, but you can go there to get up-to-date information on what's going on with golf in Lexington.
My name is Michelle Kosiniak, and I'm the Superintendent of Planning and Design for Parks and Recreation. I'm here today to announce that we are very excited that Jacobson Park Lake has been accepted into the Kentucky Department of Fish and Wildlife Resources Fishing in Neighborhoods program, which is called FINS for short.
We're pretty excited to partner with Lexington Parks and Recreation to join them into the FINS program, or Fishing in Neighborhoods, which is our urban fishing program, where we partner with the local city and county municipalities, and we stock keeper-sized fish throughout the year. Starting this fall, we're going to begin stocking rainbow trout into Jacobson Park Lake in October. We'll also stock them in February and March. In total, it'll be 12,000 rainbow trout that we'll stock in the lake. We'll also be stocking keeper-sized channel catfish starting next March. In total, it'll be 9,200 channel catfish. That'll be about a pound average. These are big keeper-sized fish that if somebody wants to keep some fish, they can take some home. But we also will have a new set of fishing regulations out here. We're going to be stocking a lot of large keeper-sized fish, and to help spread out the harvest so that they aren't all pulled out right away, we're going to have some new regs that we're going to post around the lake, and those regulations will be 5 rainbow trout a day, 4 channel or blue catfish, 1 bass, and they have to be at least 15 inches to keep them, and 15 sunfish that they can keep each day. We'll have a law enforcement presence out here to educate and inform people of the new regulations, as well as enforcing to make sure people have the proper fishing license. We'll also be doing a tagging study at the lake where we'll be tagging some of the fish that are stocked, and that gives us an idea for how quickly the fish are getting caught and harvested, if they're being kept or caught and released. And we'll be tagging about 900 catfish and 900 rainbow trout in the next year. Lexington Parks is going to be putting in a fishing pier. We're going to be doing some habitat improvements around the lake, adding some structure to attract fish around that pier. We've put in some spawning structures to increase reproduction for largemouth bass. We'll also be doing routine sampling out here to sample the bass and sunfish populations to see if stocking is necessary on those as well.
For anyone who isn't familiar with Jacobson Park Lake, it's a 46-acre lake, and it's surrounded on one side with 222 acres of parkland, lakeside golf course, an 18-hole golf course on the other. All the bank is cleared, so there's lots of fishing opportunity. And as Dane mentioned, we're going to be constructing a fishing pier this fall. The exciting thing about this fishing pier is that it will be handicap accessible. While here at Jacobson Park, you can also take advantage of our boat ramp. For $3, people are welcome to launch non-gasoline-powered watercraft. Other amenities available near the fishing spots, we have restrooms, picnic shelters, and a playground. And we encourage people to stay for the day, enjoy fishing, and take advantage of those amenities. One thing we would ask is if you visit Jacobson to fish, please park inside the park in the designated paved parking lots. We strongly discourage, for safety reasons, anyone parking along the shoulder of Richmond Road to fish the lake. Also, when you come to the park, you'll notice that we have, at certain times a year, a large population of migratory waterfowl. We ask for your safety and the health of these birds that you do not feed the birds while you are here at Jacobson.
Hello, my name is Eric Howard, volunteer coordinator for the Division of Parks and Recreation at LFUCG. I want to answer the question about volunteer opportunities with our division. We have any number of opportunities for individuals or groups, starting with adopting a Legacy Trail garden bed. This is a naturalized bed that just requires a volunteer to go out a couple of times a month, making sure that the beds are in good working order, no weeds, no trash, no signs of any foul play or vandalism. We also have Adopt-a-Trail segments at the Legacy Trail. This is a half-mile segment where you visit it periodically, make sure there's no trash on the trail, and report any problems that you might see. In addition to that, we have athletic opportunities for coaches and volunteers to work with our youth and sports environment. There are also opportunities in our parks with cleanup projects such as clearing honeysuckle from areas of the park, clearing trash from creek beds and other park areas, and clerical opportunities such as filing and telephone reception work at the Bell House and the McConnell Springs and Raven Run Nature Sanctuaries. Feel free to call me about any of these opportunities at 288-2984. Thank you.
Oh, it's always a good time.
The Lexington Art League and Parks and Recreation have had a long established relationship. We do offer the Woodland Art Fair in partnership with Parks and Recreation each year. They provide unbelievable support for that event. We are very fortunate to have a very thriving and vibrant community that really has grown through the arts in many different ways. Parks and Recreation is a great supporter of the arts in our community.